Do you have an FDM 3D printer? Do you want to manufacture a printed circuit board which is just spot on? Then please follow me. We will need painter's tape, electric tape, double-sided tape, a permanent pen, some rubber bands, and etching agent. Use a pen with a tip as thin as possible. Mine is an 0.3 adding. When designing the PCB, set the trace width to the same as the size of the tip of your pen. Keep in mind that drawing with a pen is not 100% accurate. To have good results, make straight connections and avoid traces or pads being too close to each other. When you are happy with the design, export it in Gerber format. Download PCB converter tool from the link in the description and open it. Select the Gerber file and you can remove the drill file. Then adjust all the settings. Select printing method. Set the nozzle dial meter to the size of the tip of your pen. Set printing speed to 400. Adjust the layer mirror if necessary. Z safe has to be set to 2 mm, edge milling speed to 400 mm, and then thick cut edges checkbox. The warning can be ignored. Then check the results and save the G-code file. This file is not suitable for printing because it contains the O2 command, which most printers do not understand. We can make fine-tuning by downloading the Excel file from the link in the description. It contains a formula which replaces the G02 commands with a series of G01, so the printer will draw a square instead of a circle. The size of the square can be adjusted on the second worksheet. Paste the text into the first column and grab the transformed content from the second one. Finally, remove all the quotation marks. You can check the results by going to ncviewer.com, drag and drop the G-code file and simulate the movements of the pen. The pen holder is 3D printed and looks like this when it's ready. Apply double-sided tape to the back, cut the excess away, and then attach it firmly to the side of the printer head. Make sure that it's in a perfectly upright position. After leveling the build plate, we can attach the circuit board using painter's tape. The wider the tape, the better the grip. Then let's send the printer head to the home position. Then we must wrap some electric tape right next to the tip of the pen. It will act as a stopper, making sure that the pen is in a perfect position. Now it's time to fasten the pen to the printer head with rubber bands. Add as many bands as necessary to make the pen sit properly. We can finally start printing. Raise the printer head a bit so the pen doesn't bump into the build plate. Then maneuver the pen above the starting point and slowly lower so the tip of the pen touches the PCB. Now turn the printer off and back on again. It will set the zero to the current position. Now run the G-code and watch the magic happen. After printing, you may have to make minor adjustments by hand. Then soak the PCB into etching chemical like natrium persulfate. When all the copper has been dissolved, remove the paint with nail polish remover. Et voila! The PCB is ready for drilling and soldering. Please give a thumbs up and subscribe if you liked the video. Cheers and thanks for watching.